Hello everyone, welcome to Code Enzyme. And in this video, I will discuss how you can resolve these issues like hash include bits, stdc, C++ in Mac, and how to use policy based data structures. And I'm using M1 Mac, so ideally, the same step should work for M2 and other versions like Intel chip, but I have tested this only on my M1 Mac for now. So you can try and follow this ahead, and if it also works for you and you are on some other Mac versions, kindly comment it down so I get to know that if this works for you or not. Okay. And this is in response to a comment. So if you have any other doubts as well, you can comment down and I will probably make a video on it. The last thing I want to say is that majority of my viewers have not subscribed to my channel, and this is a really new channel. So if you can subscribe, it will really help me a lot. So kindly like this video, subscribe to my channel, and let's start. Now what is happening here is that why are we even getting this error? This means that if you are trying to include bits stdc C++ in your Mac and it is giving you an error, it means that wherever this compiler is searching for this file, this is not present, right? So what is happening here is let me zoom in a bit. If you type G++ and press enter, then G++ is not being used here. Clang is used here, right? So if I say G++ minus V, you will see that this G++ is actually provided by your Xcode, and it is actually just a Clang version, and it does not have these policy based data structures and bits stdc C++ file. Okay, so if you want to use this in your Mac, but so you will need to install a few things. First thing you will need is a homebrew, so let's just search for that. Homebrew, and the first link should get you here. Just copy this and you can paste it here. I'm not doing that because I have already installed it and I don't want to mess up my file structure. Ideally, you need to install this homebrew on your Mac and add it to path. Adding it to the path is must. So now when you type brew here, this should come up. Let me just clear it and type it again for you. Yeah. So now when you type brew here, all these things should come up here. Brew install, brew info, and that. Okay, so now what we are going to do is from now on we are not going to use G++. We are going to install a new version of GCC using this homebrew. So I'm going to say brew install GCC. Okay, and you will press enter, but I will not because I've already installed this GCC in my computer. So once this is installed, what you can do is brew list, and if your Mac is new and you have not used homebrew much, ideally there will be a very few packages only, but I've used it quite a lot, so I have many packages in my computer, and there you will see one of the packages is GCC. So GCC is installed. Now I can do brew info GCC, and this will give you the directory where GCC is installed. So opt homebrew seller GCC and 13.1.1.0. This tells me that GCC version 13 has been installed. So now if I just clear it, now if I do G++ minus 13 and dash V, so you can see after doing this step, it will take some time, but after your everything is downloaded, ideally your G++ should be added to path. And once this is added, when you do this, you will realize that it is actually installed in this directory, opt homebrew seller GCC and your version and so on. Okay, now I hope you were able to reach it till this point. G++ minus 13 is installed in your MacBook, and now we have to configure our VS Code such that it is using this 13th version of G++ in the homebrew and not the G++ of the VS Code. Okay, first thing we want to do is we want to set the default compiler. So open your settings and go to settings, search for default settings.json, and you will see this blue link, open default settings JSON. And what this does is it gives you all the default settings in your VS Code, right? Now, one thing we want to specify is the default compiler. So I hope you have installed these extensions like C++ extension pack and the code runner. I want you to install this code runner. It helps you in running the your code. And the last extension that is pretty much optional, but when I do competitive programming, I use this extension called competitive programming helper. So you can install that too. Okay. So we need to, so once you have installed this, come here and open your default settings.json. And in here, I will say, okay, C_CPP default dot compiler path. Okay. Okay. So we have a default compiler commands and default compiler path. As you can see, the default compiler path is null. So the VS Code doesn't know that it has to use the homebrew version and it is using the Xcode version. So let's just copy this here. Go to your settings and open your settings.json from here. Okay. And in here, I'm going to paste this. And in this null, I have to get the path of my, the path of the compiler, right? So I will say, I will just open my spotlight and say, okay, opt/homebrew. Okay, it should be small h, but let's see. I will go to seller. Then I think it was gcc. Then I don't remember what was the next folder, so I will just open it at my gcc. Then I will go to this 13th version. Then let's go to bin, and we want to get the get this file g++-13. Okay, so let's just press command I to get the information on it. And now we have to copy the path of this file. Where can we get that? Or what we can do is simply open this in VS Code. Whatever, and now I will just copy the path, copy path. Okay, and in here I can paste it. You can even type this yourself, you don't need to if you want. If it's the same, I think the version is the only thing that will change for you. So once you have your version, you can type this here. And as you can see, once you specify this, your errors are gone. At least your VS Code is not showing you any errors. Your bits stdc++ error is gone, and even these two files are these, and your policy based data structures are working. So now what you can do is let's try to use this like indent cnn, and let's see if this is working, because we also want to run our files, right? So first let's try the code runner. And you can see it is giving us errors. Like even though our VS Code is using this compiler path, the code runner doesn't know that he has to use VS G++ 13th version, right? So now you can go to this here, and we want to, okay, let's again open the default settings, and let's search for code runner. Let's search for executor map. Yeah. And in here I have to specify that I am going to use my G++ 13th version. So let's go here, and in this I am going to specify for my C++ and Python, because I am a C++ and Python coder. In here I am going to say G++-13, and one more tag I am going to use is O2, because sometimes it helps with some things. And I'm going to use my C++ 17 version. So stdc equal to C++ 17. It's 17, right? And if you want, you can also specify for your Python using, just take the default command here As you can see, by default it is using Python 2 in Mac. Now you can make it Python 3 to avoid any errors. And once this is done, I think this will start working. And okay, it is waiting for me to. Okay, so your code is compiling now, and you should be able to run it. But if I do this, you can see. But if you are using competitive programming helper, you can still see this error. Now, how do we tackle that? And instead of going to default compiler command, we will set up the language command. So search for cph.cpp.language command. And if you do that, you can see that it is using G++. Now we are going to change it. And let's go there again. And in here, I'm going to specify that I'm going to use -13 version. And as soon as and also one more thing I will change is that I forgot to add here. I am going to add two more arguments, that is -stdc++17 in my cph.language.cpp.args. This will add these arguments in my while running them. So now if I save it, like code runner is working, but if you want to use cph also, you can now use it, and this should work. And as you can see, we are getting the correct output, and your order set and your policy based data structure should also be working. If I do insert 1, insert 2, order of key, let's put a star here, and cout endl. Let's see if this is working, and what is the error now? Star must be a pointer. Sorry about that. And now you can see that our policy based data structures are also working. Okay, because one will be at the zeroth position, so we are getting that output. And if you were able to set up your VS Code, kindly comment it down so I know that I helped someone at least. Kindly like this video and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any other doubt, make sure you comment, and I will probably make a video on it. So thank you guys. See you next time.